Well, howdy, 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 folks. I am glad you're with me. I am excited about tonight. I'm wearing the lunch pad. It's right here, right here. See, it's backwards in my screen. Lunch pad right there, shirt that he sent me. And I am, we're covering a lot tonight. This is Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. And this is episode number 167. I am glad that you're with me. And we're going to be answering a ton of questions. If you have questions, comments, please post them in the little comment thing down below. And we'll get going. All right. So the first item up for grabs is the vendor of the week. Vendor of the week. Guess who it is? Can you guess? Diz's Hot Dogs. Diz's Dogs. Okay. It's D-I-Z apostrophe S Dogs. And you can find them the same way, DIZSDOGS.com. Our goal is to deliver awesome hot dogs with a smile and fun. I don't know if y'all saw the picture, okay, of Diz's Dogs. He pulls around a big dog cart with a grill loaded up. I'm talking loaded up big dog with a Harley. It is sexy. Okay, congratulations, Diz's Dogs. Thanks for being here. I think it's awesome. Now, let's see. Oh, look here. Chef Jose's in the house. Greg Crafton's here. Dolan Slimp's here. Carl Harmon's here. And Heather's with us. D.L. Turner. Glad you're with us, brother. All right, so that is the first thing. Now we're going to jump to questions. You ready for some questions and answer stuff? Here's where it gets fun. But let's see. First question. Hey, Ben, how do I overcome this feeling like nobody or next to nobody will come and stop at my cart? I've been excited and upbeat about the possibilities of doing well, but still I'm putting all my cards out there, so I'm a little nervous. Well, I just did a article in the blog, learnhotdogs.com. It's right near the top somewhere about my first day vending, and I talk about this. I talk about this, how I was nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs nervous. It is scary, and I had those same fears. In fact, we made a top 40 questions new vendors have on their first day, and you can find that at learnhotdogs.com/40, and one of those questions is, what if nobody shows up? Well, that doesn't happen. Okay, unless you find some long, dark road somewhere in backwoods Tennessee and hide and put up a gate, you're going to get some people. So as long as you get out there in front of people, you're going to get some business. Some people, it'll just be curious. I had people pulling over going, what is that contraption you got there? Nobody had seen a hot dog cart over there in you know, East Tennessee. It's just, it wasn't something they saw. Maybe on the movies now, but this is a realistic fear because you go, what if I'm out there and nobody comes? Well, nobody'd know that nobody came except for you, right? It's not like you're going to have a crowd standing there going, boy, I wish it's almost 1:30 and nobody showed up yet. It won't be like that. You'll have customers. Get a good location. You'll have customers. Get about any location. You're going to have customers, but I want you to get a good location. I've got some awesome courses that are free over at learnhotdogs.com on different locations and things to look at. But I can't really, other than telling you bourbon, that'll take the edge off of that fear of nobody coming. But it's a normal fear, but it's not something you are going to have to deal with. It's not going to happen. Okay. I've had some vendors have bad first days. Nobody I've ever heard of ever did nothing. Okay. So, I had what you would call a bad day. I did about $93, my first day, and it wasn't that bad, but I've heard of vendors doing $40 and $50 on the first day. Not the end of the world. There could be different things causing that. That's the whole reason, you know, I keep teaching and training, is because there is something going on and we can figure it out. We can get to the bottom of it. Let me move on to the next question. A question from Joseph. It says, Ben, thank you for dedicating your time and effort to to enlightening my understanding of the HD health department. We passed inspection and are very close to slinging our first dogs. Congratulations, Joseph. I just watched your video, Be a Peanut, and it set off a flood of light bulbs. We are originally from East Coast, and the one thing I really miss are those roadside hot boiled peanut stands. Nobody out here sells them, so we would like to be the people to introduce them folks to them. Do you have any good recipes, and do you happen to know a distributor to get a large quantities of raw peanuts? Here's what I would do. Okay. Before I started getting in raw peanuts, they take forever to boil down. When you're boiling lots of them, you got to get a huge, like a 20 gallon pot, you know, turkey burner under it. And it takes a long time. Okay. A lot of them use cast iron pots and it's a process, right? I would just buy some, and you can buy those through a broadline distributor or even through Cisco, one of these distributors. There is a brand called Peanut Patch, and you've probably seen it. It's in all the convenience stores in the South, and it is a pretty good peanut. Okay. Depending on the time of year that can came from. Because what they'll do is they'll store peanuts and then they'll boil them. And so you may not be getting green peanuts. Everybody likes green peanuts. Even though every can they have says fresh green boiled peanuts. No, they're not. Okay. So that's what I would tell you to do first. Buy them and try them before you go into making peanuts. Now, if you wanted to have a vat going with them, well, they're already done. It doesn't hurt them a bit to boil. So boil them up. Throw in some seasonings. Okay. You can throw in salt, pepper. Some people put in garlic. You could put in, I like cayenne, you know, like the Cajun hot boiled peanuts. You can do that. You could even use Zataran, something like that if you wanted to. And you can even change the flavor of those. My daughter and I, we buy them in the number 10 cans and we jack them up. So we make them hotter than what they say they are. And by boiling them, you'll soften them up even more, which is even better. I hope that answers your question, Joseph. And I'm happy that you're pursuing that. If y'all haven't seen that video, it's a good video, I think. Look at that. I'm patting myself on the back. About Be a Peanut. And it's not about really about selling peanuts. It's not about that. It's about being a peanut. And you'll see why if you watch the video. It's a secret. Can't tell you. It'd have to kill you. All right. I was hoping to get some info on how to man a cart. Should or would I need 2-person team? And in what situations would I need a helper? It is always, always good to have a helper. Always. But you don't need one. Okay. I've got videos on learnhotdogs.com where you can watch vendors do hundreds of people and be by themselves. I filmed them. Okay. So I have seen vendors just do an amazing job. I get stressed out when the line gets long. I'd rather have a helper. I'd rather have somebody taking the tickets or taking the cash and then telling me what to make. And then I'll hand it over to the customer. That's the easiest way. Do you need one? No. Have I vended without one? Yes, lots. But I always prefer to have someone there. It makes life easier. It doesn't even kind of have to be though. All right. Next question. This was from Bob Abraham. I have a question I wished I could have asked during the interview the other day. I guess that was with, Rick. Yeah. Yeah, it is Rick. Did Rick have any problems with the city about being able to stay in one location? Have not heard, didn't ask, didn't see the question, Bob. I apologize. Hit him up on Facebook and ask him. He never told me of any problem like that. But that probably, he's on he's not on Facebook, but you can still get a hold of him through Facebook, because there's the lady that goes there all the time. You know, the lady that works at the news station, or the radio station, personality lady. Let's see. Question from the KC kid. Question from the KC kid. I was trying to pronounce, I mean, you know, sound out using my homegrown, whatever you call that, phonics, hooked on phonics. The KC kid, I asked last week about the hot dog roller. Yes. Health department said no, unless I have a stand that is enclosed building. An enclosed building. My next question, like I said, I am on the cheap end right now. I see a cart that is 3 hours away that is in my ballpark price. It has a small sink on it. I saw on eBay a three-bay sink for $149. How hard would it be to install the sink on it? There's enough room on the other side of the cart. Also, I was thinking I have checked around my area. Is it possible I could rent one? Would I have to meet all the rules as well? So I could get my feet wet, and if I like it, any tips would be thankful. I saw a machine like a regular sink or drink machine, but it makes hot dogs, bun, everything weird, kind of cool. Have you seen this? What do you think? Okay, let me tell you that one real quick. I have seen the machine that does the whole deal, a vending machine. Supposed to be pretty good. Guy filmed it. It's on YouTube. I haven't tried it, though, and I've never seen one in person. Now, to get to your questions on the sink, you don't need to buy a sink or a sink set on eBay for $149. You can do it all yourself for less, and I show you how. I just showed you how last week. I believe there is a, on the blog, there is an article that tells you how to upgrade a cart if you need more than one sink, or it came with no sinks, how to upgrade the hot water, the whole deal. All that's easily done, fairly easily done, and you can do it all for less than the $149, that just for the three sinks. You don't need those three sinks probably, but we have that there. Now, you also asked, I was thinking, I have checked around my area, is it possible you rent one? Yes, I teach how to find ones that may be available for rent, or even ones they don't know for rent. How to contact a vendor and see what days he's not using it or she's not using it, and see if you can use it, rent it from them. A lot of vendors would say yes to that. That may be a good option for you. And I've got a thing on that on the blog as well. It's called, I did one today. It's on the blog, and it's called, it'll be one of the first top blog articles, can't afford a hot dog cart. And there's a whole list of stuff you can do and how to get started without a hot dog cart. Okay. That'll help you a ton. Go check that out. KC kid. Let's see. Would I have to meet the rules if I rented one? Well, typically if you're renting one that's owned by another vendor, that one's already been approved. So yeah, you still follow the rules, but it's already an approved cart. That's another benefit to kind of break into the business, is to use a cart that's already licensed. You know, get your feet wet. Speaking of renting a cart, if you are in Florida, specifically, I was looking for that word. That was taken a little bit. Specifically in the north middle of Florida, the middle of the state, but North Florida. Okay. Near Live Oak, near Jasper, White Springs. The actual town is called Bell. There is a cool dude that, his town got ransacked too with the storm. In fact, they're still out of power from the hurricane. Okay. And he has a huge event. Everything got flooded. He has a huge event on Saturday. He would like to rent a cart. Okay. And I'm fixing to give you the number. But he would like to rent a cart. In fact, I'm going to put the number here. If you have a cart that you're not going to use this Saturday, please contact him. He needs help badly. It's already a scheduled gig. They need it. And I know we got vendors all the way from, you know, the tip of the panhandle, Tallahassee, all the way Chattahoochee, all the way to, you know, Live Oak, Lake City, Jacksonville. He'd probably drive and go get it. I mean, for real, he needs it bad. His name is Bart, like Bart Simpson. Okay. 352. Let's see. I'm going to put his, I'm putting it in the comments right now. That's his number. Okay. Don't call him and harass him and breathe heavy on the phone and do that crazy stuff. Just call him up if you have a cart. He is needing one badly, and I would appreciate if you'd help him out. He will rent it. He'll pay for it no matter what. Just get going. He doesn't want to lose the money he could make on this event, and I don't blame him. From the Bronx one. I guess that's like Bronx, New York. Okay. I did get me a small hot dog cart. It was perfect, small, not too heavy, plenty of space for other items, sodas, condiments, a legal hot dog cart for me. But there was one problem. I'm from New York. New York City Health Department refused to issue a vendor's permit. Still today, no one can get one. The only way is to rent the permit. Okay, so what he's talking about is in some big, big cities, they have a certain number of permits for public property. So like at the Metropolitan Museum, that one's gone for like $500,000, just one permit. They bid it out. Okay. There's a vendor who works by himself and puts out a dog about every 4 seconds, 4 to 6 seconds. They've actually filmed him, not me. The news station filmed him. He's that quick. Okay. Now those big cities have limited number of spots. You have to buy them, right? Or rent them, whatever, buy a permit for them. Bid on them, some of them auction them like that. But that doesn't stop you from vending. I'm the first person, and I've been screaming this for years, don't be on the street corner vending right now. Unless you've got a dang good spot, go elsewhere. There's so many good locations that nobody's after that you will rock. What about in front of a hospital? Think about that. Cafeteria closes at what time? About 4. What? Well, do they close the hospital? No, there's still a lot of employees, a lot of people coming over to see their sick loved ones or whatever. Okay. And you're out there. Do you know how many hospitals would love that? Lots of them, because we got a bunch of vendors that already do it. What about the vendors in front of the pull aparts that this Saturday will be there? These auto parts and auto salvage places, they're awesome places for that. Flea markets. There's so many places you don't need to buy or rent or anything, a location. I hate paying for a location. Don't want to, ain't going to. Don't do it. Okay. Now, from Rubicle, do I need a commissary if I do not prepare anything myself? Yes, because you've got to clean. And in most states, they're going to require a commissary for your cleaning. Because you're going to, even if you're not preparing it, you're taking it out there and you're keeping it hot or warming it up. You're going to have some dirty utensils. They're going to want you to be able to wash everything. And typically that requires a commissary. They're also going to ask, where are you storing everything that you didn't prepare? Okay. Where are you storing 80 pounds, you know, of hot links and, you know, 200 pounds of hot dogs and your onions? You're going to be storing those somewhere. They'd like it to be in a commissary. Now you can ask your health department, because I have to have a commissary. There are people in Tennessee that don't have to have one because the health inspector said, oh, he's got four sinks on his cart, even though they're this big. He's got four sinks on his cart. He doesn't need a commissary. And they won't make him get one. Okay? Blows my mind. But who am I to argue? I'm glad that works out that way. I wish it had worked out for me. Okay? Billy Taylor says, Ben, have you used Square Payments Order Ahead service? Well, I found out about that from my good friend, Jason Brown of Love Food Truck. They used to do that for free. They then bought another company that had a better system for doing that. And now you'll pay double the fees to get that done. And so I looked it up as well, and it's a pain in the neck to do that pay ahead service, order ahead service. The video I did with I know it's not perfect as far as the process, but it's easy once you set it up on a Google form, and then you'll get emailed. Oh, look, the sheriff's department's coming to pick up 61 hot dogs and 2 of these and 3 of these and 9 of these. Okay. That works out great. That's just easy. And then you don't have to pay nobody nothing for that. And I like paying nobody nothing. Let me see. Speaking of peanuts, you remember the peanut video I talked about earlier in this show, right? Well, I got sent earrings, peanut earrings. Look here. This is so cool to me. I rarely get handwritten letters. This is a handwritten letter, okay? Front and back. I'm talking a big letter. With a peanut Christmas ornament. I fooled you with the earring thing, didn't I? A Christmas ornament peanut, because he read or watched my video on Be a Peanut. And if you'll be a peanut, you'll say, well, you already are a peanut, but be one. Be a peanut. And if you'll watch that video, hopefully Heather can link you to that video or the blog where the article where that video is. You need to be a peanut. The other thing, booyah. Another friend. Look at that. A pen that is a hot dog. Okay? A pen. And it even says hot dog. So isn't that cool as heck? So thank y'all. Thank y'all a bunch. Cody Terrell, thank you for sending me the Duma Flicky here. I want the other earring though, just so you know. I hope that helped y'all, and I hope that you that I didn't miss anything or shortchange you at all. Let me go through these real quick. Dustin Smith's here. Hey, it's Michelle with Electric City Hot Dogs and More Catering. Thanks for being here. Chris Kastner, thanks for being here. Frankenstein's, Peter, a growing pains. Got to go through it. That's right. Amanda Cooper's in the house. Brett Staden, hey, everyone. Hey, Brett, glad you're here. Yep, Electric City says people will come. It may be slow the first day. It's okay. Exactly. I'd rather it be slow on my first day. I'd like it to be slow for the first 3 or 4 days, unless I had already done enough of my practice runs where I did my friends and family, or maybe went to the church and donated and said, hey, I'm going to feed everybody today. Let's try this. Now the only difference is when you're doing friends and family, nobody's handing you money, and that can throw you for a little loop. You got to get used to wearing one glove or the big slip on gloves that you pull out. They're disposable and you sling them down. Let's see. Look, Mr. Warren Russell's in the house. Warren Russell, I don't know if y'all follow Warren. Y'all need to be following him. Okay, go to lemonadevending.com. Check out Warren's lemonade squisher smasher thingamabob. And then check out, he doesn't just make these, okay, and build them from scratch and ship them all over the world, okay? He actually does it. And he helps support his family and his extended family all with a lemonade smisher smasher thingamabob. Okay? You ought to check it out. Let's see. Boiled peanuts and bacon boiled together is good, good, good. Carl, you're exactly right. I love it. Beatbox Rob, is it worth it to do part-time on weekends? I'm in Tampa, Florida. You know what? If Michael Wood was here right now, he could answer this for you real quick because he's been with us about 8 years as of yesterday. As of yesterday was his 8-year anniversary. Okay. And Beatbox Rob, abso-freaking-lutely. He started, in fact, this is his first year working more than 3 days a month. He's averaged 3 days a month for the last 8 years or 7.5, whatever it is. Okay. And then this year he went to six days now. Double timing it. Is it worth it? It's with his 3 days, he's doing a full-time income with his 3 days. Okay. So yes, it's worth it. Holy moly. I can let you talk to Chef Jose here. He hasn't even got a cart yet, and he's working it only when he can, because he works 6 days a week and only has Sunday off sometimes. And when he does that without a cart, okay, without a cart, mind you, in 3 weekends, so 3 Sundays, I can tell you what he put it in his own words. He's got a video. He did 500 the first one, 1,000 roughly the second one, the third Sunday, he did over $3,000 with lemonade and hot dogs. Let's see, John Russell's here. Thanks for being here. First time on here, Ben. This is Earl Kennedy. I've been watching your videos. I called today my local health department to get the info on the food class. They said that there are two different classes, a management class and another class. Which class should I take? Also, how hard is it to take and pass the class? The class is simple, okay? Simple as pie, simple, okay? the manager class just allows you, like some states require that if you're the owner of the cart, you have the manager license, then you can have employees who have the regular life, you know, the regular health. Not all states require that, but some do. Mine doesn't. A lot of them don't, but some do. It's not a big deal. I'd go ahead and get the manager one. It shows effort on your part to the health department. They'll be like, oh, you got the manager? You didn't need the manager. Yeah, but I wanted to hire other people, and I want to be able to show them exactly what to do so we can keep the people safe with my hot dogs. Does that make sense, Earl? I hope so. Denver Johnson's in the house. Thanks for being here, Denver. Get Ben's day in the life of a hot dog vendor. Absolutely right. DL, thank you for that. Sorry, guys, just back, got to the commissary. Look at there. Docking his pay. Jason's all the time talking about who he's going to dock their pay for not showing up. He didn't show up in time. He blames it on working and stuff. I don't believe him. Probably out paddleboarding. Earl, is take the management class as good for 5 years of serve safe. Owen Lewis, thanks for the advice, brother. Mike Scarlett, trying to convince my wife she's fighting me so hard. Mike, I have something for you. And Heather, if you can hear me, please post this up for Mike. Well, you can get it posted for everybody. Naysayers. Well, Mike, you can go to learnhotdogs.com and go to the side to where the search box is and type in the word naysayer, like naysayer. Okay. That go there, type that in. I cover this and I did it fairly recently again, and that will give you a good idea. That is natural. That's natural. Okay. Don't worry about it. And I actually will give you some advice there to show you how to handle that situation, because it is normal to for your friends and loved ones, especially because they want to protect you. They don't want to be, they'd rather be the ones that say, I told you shouldn't have done that, than to tell you, well, dang, I wished I hadn't told you to go ahead and do that. You see what I'm saying? So the nice part about vending like this is, let's say you went out, you did this like this, you know, crazy, went crazy with it, got the Cadillac of the carts, and oh, I'm going to build my commissary, and you spent a bunch of money. The neat thing about this business is you can leave anytime you want, sell the business. If you have a good location making money, you can sell it as a business. Okay. Sell the location, sell the cart, sell the whole kit and caboodle, right? Sell your license, sell it all. Or most carts, especially during prime season from about March through about October in the, you know, mostly in the South, Southern United States, and then it tapers off the further north you get, but you can get a premium for a used hot dog cart because it's here and now. Okay. You can double check me on this. There's people selling my carts used for more than I sell a new one for. And you go, well, why didn't they check? You know? Some of them do check, and then they go, oh, I can have this one right now, or I can wait on Ben to ship me one. I'll take the right now. And they do it. Let's see. Get the Hot Dog Saved My Life book. So much great info. Thank you, Owen. I appreciate that. Here's that number again. If anybody's got a cart, North Central Florida. That's the way I was trying to word that earlier, and I butchered it up. James in the house. Thanks for being here, James. Aaron's in the house. Glad you're here, Aaron. Can you add lemonade sales such as Warren's Rig to your hot dog vending without more HD red tape or licensing? I'm in Arizona. It's different in different places. I'm going to tell you, check with them. Okay, because some places like Tennessee code says that I cannot prepare a drink on the cart. I have to bring it already lit it up. Have I done it? Yep. So it depends on where, like if you're doing a catering or event, yeah, that doesn't matter. But if you're street side vending, check with your state, see if they go, well, we don't want you doing lemonade. Because they may not. But most everywhere everywhere you can do lemonade, just some of it's not on the street. Can't fresh press it unless it's an event or catering, something like that. Private. Yeah, Electric City said car dealerships. That was answer the other question about, you know, starting out, and they say, oh, you can't be here, you can't be there. AC just went out at my house. Good thing I have a hot dog cart to pay for it. Michael Wood. We had somebody ask, I don't know how long you've been here, but somebody asked about, can you make a living on this working part-time? Is it worth it to make, you know, is it worth it to then part-time? They didn't even say, can you make a living? They just said, is it worth it? Let's see. I have to use my restaurant in Watertown. Okay. I got to get up to Wisconsin. Some great vendors up there. Yeah. I want to travel the country and go visit vendors. It'd make me happy as heck. Okay, here's that Be a Peanut link. You talking about, this will make you feel better. I'm telling you, there's nothing to buy. Just go watch the dang video, and be a peanut. How you like that? I cannot wait to get the other earring. Let me know when you do. I will. One earring, you'll be a peanut pirate. That's right. If you sling them, people will eat them. That's right. That's right. James will be soon, Watertown, Wisconsin. Newbie Jackie Sanchez, welcome and thanks for being here. I hope you're getting value out of this. Some of this may be beyond what you need, but that we always cover some stuff that helps, you know, a broad range. Let's see. Michael Wood, part-time is better. He would say that. He'd say that. Just got my card a week ago. Can't wait to get out. Still having trouble with Michigan licensing. Cosmic dogs in the house. Mike Pack. Yeah, Michigan can be stickler. In fact, if I had to list the two toughest states to start in, okay, would be California and Michigan. Now, not everywhere in Michigan and not everywhere in California, but if I had to pick two states, those would be the two that I'd say are the toughest. Jose Pinto says, yes, it's worth it. Let's see. You front need management class unless you're employees. If you don't need, yep, food handlers. Let's see. Look, Heather put up. She is so good. She's fast. Naysayer's going to nay. Let's see. Mike Scarlett, you're welcome. Thanks for being here. Just took the ServSafe Manager course this past Monday and highly recommend it. I understand that Mike Scarlett having the same problem. I've stated it shut down, but I'd be darned if I'm out because it works, brother. Amen. Lucky Dog Concessions coming in 2 weeks. Hoo-wee. Jim, I'm with you, brother. I'm with you. I would love to start my hot dog food business, but they say it takes money to make money. Hard to do anything when you are broke. Joshua, we just put up a link right down below your comment. You need to check it out. How to start a hot dog cart with no money. How to start with no money. I'm serious. I spent a lot of time and did a kick butt. But I, again, pat myself on the back, blog article today. And I put it out this morning. Can't afford a hot dog cart. And it gives you everything you can do and people that have done it. Cheryl right here. Chef Jose right here. You talking about low on funds and low on time. Chef Jose. So you've got plenty of people to help you and plenty of avenues to go without needing money to make money. Okay. You don't need a gop. You don't need to go, you know, get a loan and, you know, sell three of your kidneys. I would love to start my food business. Do you think it's worth it to join the Chamber of Commerce? It is in some places. If your chamber is real active, it absolutely is because of the networking. But now with social media, honestly, you can network even faster. I'm fixing to help my daughter, and we've bought these miniature jars. I'm going to show all y'all. She's part of the Roasting Nomad Tribe, and it's the pig rotisserie, the hog cooker, the vegetable cooker, the seafood cooker, that whole cooker thing. You can go to roastingnomad.com if you want to see it, what I'm talking about. But I'm helping her, and what we're going to do is not the Chamber of Commerce first. We've made little gift baskets with these little jars I found online that look like little tiny honey jars. We're going to fill one with honey. Okay. And we're going to fill the other one with barbecue sauce. And we're going to deliver those out with her business. Look, Roasting Nomad. There's that pig cooker I just said. Okay. Then it's got a whole back of goodness. It's just cool as crap. So anyway, we're going to be doing that. So yes and no. Join the chamber. Once you have the money to join the chamber, some Chamber of Commerce, you know, $1,000 a year. Some of them are $200 a year. Some of them maybe $50 a year. I don't know what yours is, but there's a lot of ways to get your name out there without that having to spend any money at first. Check out the blog on YouTube for Ben's video on starting with little to no money. Yes, just put a new one up, Owen, today. Thanks for bringing that up. Jim Roberts said the same thing. Thank you, Jim. What about when you have no money and have crap credit? Not easy. So easy to get capital to start, I think. Joshua, you'll have it solved, brother. I'm telling you, go read that article today I put. That'll help you. Doesn't matter about your credit. I had no credit, was on food stamps, had to beg, borrow, and steal to get started. And I didn't even know this stuff. I point over here because I got that article up over here. Is I got started. I didn't have this information yet, and I still got started. You can do the same. There's nothing stopping you. There's nothing between you and doing that other than air and opportunity. That's it. You just need to know what to do. I can show you what to do. In fact, I did it today. I put it out today, another one, an updated version, all that. Check it out. Be inspired. You don't need credit. Joshua, you can do it, almost ready to start here. 1 to 2 months, and I should be going. Amanda Cooper, thanks for sharing that and for the words of encouragement to Joshua. Electric City Hot Dogs and Catering. Folks, this is your business, so get out there and promote yourself. It's work, yes, but it's so worth it. Amen. Can I get an amen? Can I get an amen? All right. That is me, no money, but getting closer. Give the book, Joshua. Okay, I see what you say about getting started. What would you recommend as a place to set up in a small town? Actually cover that as well. Joshua, you're going to be bumfuzzled when you get over to the blog and you go, oh my gosh, there ain't nothing, Ben's, no stone left unturned. There isn't. Go in there. There's a search box. You can type in any word and it'll pull up 80 articles I did on that subject, and videos, all kinds of stuff. Join Vendors United. Great info and well worth the investment. Thank you, Owen. I don't think Josh should join Vendors United yet. I think Josh needs to go get the information, get started with no money. Okay. I actually show you how to start with no money. Okay. I've got two articles. One really covers the no money. One covers a little bit of money, you know, $30. So I think you, can, if you have the desire to do it, there is nothing going to stop that. Now, I don't believe in pie in the sky bullshit where people tell you, oh, you can be anything. I think that's the biggest lie parents tell kids is you can do anything you want to do. Bull crap. I want to be an astronaut. Can't be one. Okay. If 20 of us want to be astronauts, guess what? We ain't. 200 of us ain't. Okay. What do they got? Like 15 of them total worldwide or something? I mean, it's just ridiculous. You got 7 billion people on the planet and you're going to tell everybody they could be an astronaut if they wanted to be? Nope. Ben, there's still one stone, how to get winning Powerball ticket. Yes. I haven't got that yet. I don't even play. I got to start playing if I'm going to win. Let's see. I appreciate y'all a bunch. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm going to go. I know I ran long, but I hope you got the value out of it that you wanted. If I missed something or I skipped over you somehow, please let me know. Mark says, one of these days I need to send my story to you, Ben, where I have been, where I'm at, and where I'm going. I'd love it, Mark. I'd love it. We could even do a one-on-one interview that we record. We can do it through Skype or something, and then I'll post it up if you're okay with that, or we can do it live right here. Okay. You know, we can just set up a time like I did with Rick or with George and I'm losing my mind. Gus, right? Gus, was it right? I think I'm right. Anyway, we've had an awesome thing. Remember, if I know that we still have some people here, if you have a cart, North Central Florida, we got a vendor desperately needs it for Saturday. Not free. You can charge him. Have at it. He needs it. He's got a huge deal to do and needs help. Y'all have a good, George and Ken. Heather, thanks for saving my life there. George and Ken. I butchered that up. Y'all have a good one. I'll talk to you later. Thanks, everybody.